Now I will try this with paper. The readings are below 50% of my do-it-yourself smoke sensor. So start the fire under it. Great, it is working. The readings are now over 60 and my notification is working as well. Perfect, just perfect. It is time for another DIY project. And today I will show you how to create smart smoke sensor for Home Assistant with D1 Mini, MQ2 smoke and gas sensor and ESP Home. It is quite easy and I'll guide you through all of the steps. At the end, you can put everything in a 3D printed enclosure like this one and to leave your new smoke sensor somewhere at your home where you have Wi-Fi coverage. But that is the end, when everything is ready. Let's walk this way together to reach this point and I'll start with the needed sensors and devices for this project. This is the D1 Mini. It is an 8266 device that have a micro USB port on it and a reset button. It comes with these header pins, but they are not soldered, so you have to do that by yourself if you want to use jumper wires. I love D1 Minis, as they are so versatile and I honestly can't stop buying them, just in case, and usually this case always comes. But let's talk about the smoke and gas sensor that I will attach to the D1 Mini. This is the MQ2 sensor. It can detect smoke, methane, butane and LPG. It has several pins, VCC, ground, digital output and analog output. I'm going to use the analog output. From here you can change the sensitivity of the sensor. This MQ2 smoke and gas sensor will increase its voltage when smoke, methane, butane or LPG is detected, making it perfect for home appliance. The increased voltage of the sensor can be used in Home Assistant automations, as you are going to see later in the video. Of course, you need some wires, where I recommend to use jumper wires or so-called DuPont wires. These are the jumper wires, female to female. And the last thing that you need is a micro USB cable to power on the D1 Mini. I will leave some links in the video description if you want to buy the same devices, the D1 Mini and the sensor and the cable. Also the jumper wires. That means for around $5 and these video instructions, you can DIY smoke sensor for Home Assistant. How cool is that? Now, let's see how to connect the D1 Mini and the MQ2 sensor together. This is the MQ2 sensor and I already connected the jumper wires on it. The orange wire is connected to the VCC output of the sensor. The blue wire is connected to the ground output and the yellow wire is connected to the analog output named AO. The VCC output of the sensor will be connected to the 5V of the D1 Mini. The ground will be connected to the ground pin, like that. And the yellow cable, which is the analog output, will be connected to this pin, also named as AO on the D1 Mini. Like that. Now I can power on the D1 Mini with a USB cable. And I have a red power LED that gets turned on. This is the whole thing connected. Let me know in the comments what do you think. Are you going to try this DIY smoke sensor for Home Assistant in your home? Type simple yes or no in the comments and now you'll know for what are you talking about. I will even reply most probably with something very wise and profound like okay. Jokingly, and with not a lot of efforts, we reached the point where the hardware part of our do-it-yourself smoke sensor for Home Assistant is ready. Now let's go to the software part, where I will install ESP Home add-on inside my Home Assistant. By the way, if you do not have Home Assistant yet, check these videos of mine where I'm showing exactly that. Now, let's do this. I'll open my Home Assistant and I'll go to Configuration, Add-ons, Backups and Supervisor, Add-on Store, and I'll search for ESP Home. Here it is, install. This ESP Home installation will take several minutes. And while you are waiting, why don't you check whether you're subscribed to my channel or not? And if you're not, now it's the best time to hit subscribe. And don't forget the notification bell, because you'll be informed when I release a new video.
A few moments later,
the installation of ESP Home add-on is now complete, and I can toggle this switch to enable watchdog, to enable auto update, and to show the ESP Home link in the sidebar right here. But I'll skip all of this and I'll just hit start. Now the ESP Home add-on is started and I can open the web UI. I will use the ESP Home dashboard to add the DIY smoke and gas sensor as new device. And then I'll configure and install the ESP Home firmware on the D1 Mini. Don't worry, it's very, very easy. This is the ESP Home dashboard and I have two green buttons saying new device, new device. They are exactly the same. And I'll click on the one of them. A device needs to be connected to a computer using a USB cable to be added to ESP Home. Once added, ESP Home will interact with the device wirelessly. And we are going to do exactly that. I'm going to connect my D1 Mini with MQ2 smoke sensor to the device where Home Assistant and ESP Home is installed. And I'll hit continue. You can name your device however you wish. And I'll name my smoke sensor D1 Mini. In the network name, I have to type my Wi-Fi name and my Wi-Fi password. Then I'll click next. Select your device type. It can be either ESP32, ESP8266, or pick a specific board. My device is ESP8266, but because I know what my board is, I'll select this option. And I'll search for Wemos D1 and Wemos D1 Mini. I'll select this and I'll click next. Configuration created. You can install ESP Home now, or you can skip this. And I'll hit skip because I want to add some YAML configuration to my smoke sensor. Then I'll click on the edit button. And on the last row, I will paste these lines. You can get them from the video description. I'm saying what's my platform, what is the pin to which my smoke sensor is connected, the update interval is 1 second, the name of the sensor, you can change it to whatever you wish. I'm adding some filters. I'm saying what is the unit of measurement, it's a percent, and I can even add an icon for this. I'll hit save and then install. From this dialog, I'll select this third option, plug into the computer running ESP Home dashboard. And I'll plug my D1 Mini with the MQ2 smoke sensor to the device where ESP Home and Home Assistant are installed. In my case, it is a Raspberry Pi 4. And I'll select this. Then I'll pick a server port and the installation begins. Let's hope for the best.
A few moments later,
the installation is now complete and I have some readings. 53% with 2 decimals of accuracy. And now, if a smoke is detected, this value should increase. Based on this, I can make automations. Let's add this to Home Assistant now. Time to add our DIY smoke and gas sensor in Home Assistant, which is piece of cake. My D1 Mini smoke sensor is now online. What's better than that? I'll tell you what's better. It's better to add the device to Home Assistant. For that, I'll go to Configuration, Devices and Services, and my smoke sensor, the One Mini, is already detected, auto-discovered by Home Assistant, and I just have to click Configure. Do you want to add DSP Home Node to Home Assistant? Of course I want to do that. From here you can select an area, but I'll leave it empty and I'll just hit Finish. Now I have one device and one entity. If I click on it, I can see the Wemos D1 Mini smoke sensor and its readings, 52.25. I can add this to Lovelace. It is time to create a Home Assistant automation that will automatically trigger when gas or smoke is detected. As action of this automation, I will use a simple notification inside Home Assistant, but as I'm showing in these videos of mine, the action can be easily replaced with mobile push notifications or even automatic voice calls with text-to-speech messages. Now, let's see how to create the automation. And I can make an automation. I'll pick the first option here, do something when Wemos D1 Mini smoke sensor voltage changes. The name of the automation will be smoke is detected by my do-it-yourself smoke sensor. The trigger of this automation is partially populated because of my selection during the previous dialog, and now I just have to enter the below or the above value, and I want only the above value. If the above value goes 55%, for example, so when the voltage of the device goes above 55%, this automation will be activated and the voltage is increased when gas or smoke is detected. I'll have no conditions, and for action I'll use call service, persistent notification, create this one. As a message I'll type smoke is detected by my do-it-yourself smoke sensor, and I think I'm ready with my automation. I'll hit save. Currently my notifications, my persistent notifications are 1. Let me grab a lighter, because this MQT sensor should also detect butane that is emitted from the lighter, and I'll test this automation right now. The funniest part of this video will begin very shortly, as I'm going to simulate gas leakage to see how my DIY gas and smoke sensor for Home Assistant will react, as well as if my automation will be triggered. But first, here is a quick challenge. If everything until now is working for you, then share your success in the comment section by typing hashtag smoke sensor on. You can even tag me in Twitter with the same hashtag. I will be very, very happy to see such comments or tweets. Now, back to action. Okay, I'm ready to test this automation. I'll open the overview section of my Home Assistant. Currently, the Wemos D1 Mini smoke sensor readings are around 50%, and if they go above 55, the automation will be triggered. This is my D1 Mini and this is my MQ2 smoke sensor. Here it is. And this is my lighter. Now I will gently press the lighter button to emit some butane. As you can see, the readings are increased rapidly and the notifications are increased as well. Smoke is detected by my do-it-yourself smoke sensor. The automation is working perfectly. I will start a little fire under the sensor in order to test the smoke detection. Please, be very careful if you're trying the same at your home. Okay, I'm ready to test this do-it-yourself smoke sensor with actual smoke. For that, I'll change a bit my automation and I'll decrease the above field to 50%. So when the Wemos D1 Mini smoke sensor voltage goes above 50%, activate this automation. That is because the actual smoke, the smoke from fire, is not changing the voltage as much as the butane from the lighter, as we see that earlier. So I'll save this automation and I'll return back to my dashboard. Currently, the voltage of the smoke sensor is around 44%. So I'm ready to test this. Just a quick warning here. Do not try this part at home if you are not sure, as you may start a fire. So let's go. I'm going to use this match and this matchstick. This is my tripod, which is holding my MQ2 sensor in the air, and I'm going to start a fire. Okay, the readings are above 50 and automation is working great. Now I will try this with paper. The readings are below 50% of my do-it-yourself smoke sensor. So start the fire under it. Great, it is working. The readings are now over 60 and my notification is working as well. Perfect, just perfect. I managed to find and print on my Ender 3 V2 printer this enclosure for the DIY smoke sensor for Home Assistant. The 3D model turns out to be pretty good and I will leave a link if you want to print the same. If you find something better, don't hold it only for yourself and share it here. As summary, I'm not yet sure how reliable this DIY smoke sensor for Home Assistant will be in the years to come. But I plan to leave several of these sensors around my home and I'll test them with matches and lighters from time to time. As with any other DIY project, do not rely entirely on these sensors for your home safety and use them at your own risk. I'm about to do the same, and if I sense something wrong with the sensors, I will update my written article on my website, vejansky.com, and I will update the description below this video. It will be very beneficial if you also share your experience with these sensors. That way, we can help each other as usual. If you want to secure this channel existence, check the available methods of support in the video description. Follow me on Twitter and join my Discord server. I'm Kirill and I'm done speaking. Bye!